फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अ पेशेंट ऑफ ट्राइजेमेलर न्यूरेल्जिया इन्वॉल्विंग हर राइट V2 डिवीजन ऑफ दिस पेशेंट। माता जी, क्या नाम है आपका?
आशा देवी।
आशा देवी, क्या तकलीफ है आपको?
हमें तकलीफ है ये हमारे 2 महीने से करंट ऐसे आदमी मारता है, बोलो तो खाना खाओ तो या जैसे कुछ कुछ मतलब करंट मारता है, ऐसे नहीं मारता है। तो हम बहुत तकलीफ थी, हम बहुत परेशान थे, इतना हमको परेशानी थी कि हम बोल कर नहीं पाते थे और हमको जो डरते थे दिक्कत हमको थी कि बोलने में इतनी तकलीफ थी कि हम किसी के मुँह से जो ऐसे बन करके बस बैठे रहो कुछ बात नहीं करो और पानी पीते थे तो ऐसे करके पानी पीते थे, ऐसे करके पानी पीने के ऐसे बगल ना आए ऐसे हाथ लगाओ तो करंट ऐसे मारता था, यहाँ लगा तो करंट ऐसे आप यहाँ करंट जाता है एकदम से और इधर से कुछ दिक्कत नहीं बस यहाँ से लेकर इतना यहाँ से लेकर इतना दिक्कत।
एक बार फिर से बताइए कि शुरू कहाँ से होता है करंट? यहाँ से शुरू होकर यहाँ जाता है?
यहाँ से लेकर आटा की तरह खड़क रहे यहाँ से तो यहाँ से लेकर यहाँ तक करंट यहाँ से जाता है, यहाँ नहीं जाता है चलता है। और अगर ब्रश करो मंजिल से तो यहाँ मशहूर लगता तो करंट से मारता पड़ी जोर से, तो बस इतनी एक मशहूर से लेकर इतनी दूर से इतने जाता है और यहाँ कहीं नहीं।
दो बार करंट लगने के बीच में भी दर्द होता है या करंट लगता है उसका खत्म हो जाता है?
करंट खत्म हो जाता है,
बीच में दर्द नहीं होता?
दर्द नहीं होता, बस मुंह बंद कर दर्द नहीं होता है। अच्छा। और उसे अगर थोड़ा सा मुंह खोलो तो जब झटका ऐसे करंट मारता रहता है।
सो वी कैन हियर इन द नेटिव लैंग्वेज ऑफ द पेशेंट इन हिंदी शी इज डिस्क्राइबिंग द क्लासिकल फीचर्स ऑफ बर्कियल टाइप 1 ट्राइजेमेलर न्यूरेल्जिया। दिस इज मोस्ट प्रोबेबली इन्वॉल्विंग द V2 डिवीजन, that is the maxillary division of this patient. The pain is getting aggravated or precipitated by all the daily routine life activities as speaking, drinking water, brushing teeth or eating food. Pain is in the form of electric shock like which is radiating into the maxillary V2 division. There is no pain between two shocks. So that is again a feature of classical trigeminal neuralgia. So we have planned to do a Gasserian ganglion radio frequency ablation of the right side of this patient, that is also known as SWEETS procedure, under the CRM guidance and with the help of radio frequency pain management generator. So here we can see the foramen ovale and this is the submental position of CR. Yes. So my marker is just on the foramen ovale. So I am going to give a 1% xylocaine that this procedure should not be painful. We cannot give too much of anesthesia in this patient because we need patient cooperation to find out whether we are at the right place or wrong. This is the 22 gauge with 5 mm of active tip radio frequency cannula. I am going to use this cannula to access the gastrian ganglion of this patient. This curved tip helped me to direct the needle into the right place, also to get the right place in the gastrian ganglion to locate that again. Yeah, we are just at the right place. I am going to insert this cannula in the gun barrel direction. This is the gun barrel view of the needle where you can see only the whole needle of 9 cm as a dot. So this is the gun barrel view. So we are now about to enter the foramen ovale. Now we will take the lateral picture to know the depth of cannula. So here we can see the clivus. We are in the microscale. You can see the tip of cannula passing the zygomatic bone in the microscale, but far before the clivus, which is the end point. The RF cannula should not reach or cross or breach the boundary made by the clivus. So now we will stimulate the patient and see whether we are at the right place or not. This is a 10 cm RF electrode. It is having the thermocouple also inside this electrode. So we will first go and see the sensory and motor stimulation and then we will go for the radio frequency ablation.
So this is a radio frequency generator which is showing the stimulation mode and lesion mode. First we are going to do the stimulation, that is 2 hertz, that is for the motor stimulation, and afterward we will do the sensory stimulation on 50 hertz. सिर नहीं हिलाओ, हाथ हिला के बताओ धीरे धीरे, बढ़ते जाओ, नहीं हो रही, बस हो रही है अभी झुंझुनी, यहाँ पे तो नहीं हो रही, यहाँ पे हो रही है, यहाँ पर हो रही है झुंझुनी, यहाँ तो नहीं हो रही. सो यू कैन सी लाइक पेशेंट इज नॉट हैविंग एनी टिंगलिंग इन द मैंडिबुलर एरिया नॉर इन द ऑप्थेल्मिक एरिया. यहाँ पे हो रही है, यहाँ पर हो रही है. So this is the area which is the involved area. So we can be pretty much sure we are at the right place. This is the beauty of radio frequency ablation, that we can pinpoint. If it is coming on less than 0.15 millivolt, then it is considered to be good. And we are getting a stimulation only at 0.06 millivolt. We are going to do either 2 or 3 lesions in this patient. First lesion on the 60 degree centigrade for 60 seconds. The second lesion will be done on the 65 degree centigrade for 60 seconds. And after that we will see whether there is any corneal anesthesia or not. So our aim is to produce lesion till there is mild hypoesthesia in comparison to the other side. Not more than that. Because otherwise post-operative, too much of hypoesthesia or anesthesia may cause a lot of problem to the patient. Our machine is ready with the 60 second timer and 60 degree centigrade of temperature control. And we have given a conscious sedation. We do not use general anesthesia, injection fentanyl in the very small doses, as well as injection propofol, because we want to make our patient awake after every lesion.
Now we can start.
Bas ho gaya. So now we will make our patient awake. Mataji, aankhein khuliye. Now the important thing in radio frequency is to see 2 things. One is there should not be deep anesthesia in the involved region, and second is corneal reflex. We have to practice to check corneal reflex every time. Ma, khulo.
Yes.
So we can see corneal reflex is intact. Ma, yahan chhu raha hu aur yahan chhu raha hu. Ek jaisa hai antar hai. Ek jaisa hai. Yes. So now we can go ahead for the 65 degree lesion. Yes. The second lesion of the 65 degree centigrade for 60 seconds. The lesion has completed. Again, we will do the same exercise of checking the corneal reflex as well as the sensation in the involved and uninvolved area. Some people do it after instilling 0.5 ml of local anesthesia into the Meckel scale. That gives a good anesthesia. You do not need to give conscious sedation like we are giving, and that makes the procedure quite time economic. But in that case, we have to traditionally go for 60, 65 degree and 70 degree lesion. Some patients are having corneal reflex weakness or increased anesthesia and hypoesthesia in that sense. So this technique is considered, and this is relatively a new technique of doing the lesioning of gastrocnemius ganglion, in which after every lesion we are checking our patient. We hope that our patient will be good with minimum of hypoanesthesia in the involved area and no loss of corneal reflex, and with remarkably good pain relief. Ma, aap bolo, chhu raha hu, yahan chhu raha hu, ek kaisa hai? यहाँ छू रहा हूँ, यहाँ छू रहा हूँ, जैसा है यहाँ छू रहा हूँ, यहाँ छू रहा हूँ, जैसा है. वी कैन सेफली गो फॉर अनदर लेजन ऑफ 70 डिग्री. आंख खोल कर तुम, आंख थोड़ी सी आंख खोल कर. यस, कॉर्नियल रिफ्लेक्स इज आल्सो वेरी मच इंटैक्ट इन दिस. सो दिस इज द 70 डिग्री एंड लास्ट लेजन. द ट्रीटमेंट इज कंप्लीटेड. वी विल जस्ट रिमूव द कैनुला वंस द टेम्परेचर कम्स डाउन. And we hope that it has been a successful procedure, because we got a wonderful stimulation in the right V2 division of patient, and there was absolutely no sensation either of V3 or V1. And we did 3 lesions at 60 degree and 65 degree and 70 degree for 60 seconds each. And we checked the corneal reflex as well as the sensation in the patient's involved territory of face, and there was no loss of sensation also.
it is important to compress it at least for 2 to 5 minutes. So that's it. It is over. Let's hope for the best for our patient. Thank you.